Hello students, this is my third lecture on bulk power energy and batteries. In my previous two videos, I have completed theory and numericals of bulk power energy. In today's session, I am going to complete batteries, in which types of cells, construction, working principle of lead acid and lithium ion battery, charging, discharging and recharging processes, maintenance and precautions while handling batteries, applications, comparison, depth of charging, methods of battery charging, series parallel connection of batteries. Now see the concept of cell and battery. Now what is cell? Cell is a source of EMF. It is a device which converts chemical energy into electrical energy. But the voltage of a single cell is not sufficient to fulfill the practical requirement of practical loads. Hence, these cells are connected in series and parallel combinations. So, what is battery? Battery is the combination of various cells to obtain the desired voltage level. So, in this PPT, this is a single cell, and here the two cells are connected in series to make a battery. Now, these cells are classified into two types, primary cell and secondary cells. So primary cells are, in primary cells, chemical actions are irreversible, hence they can't be recharged. In secondary cells, chemical actions are reversible, hence they can be recharged. In primary cell, direct conversion from chemical to electrical. In secondary cell, electrical energy is present in the cell in the form of chemical energy and then converted to electrical energy. Cell is completely replaced when it goes down in case of primary cell. In case of secondary cell, the cell is recharged back when it goes down. In primary cell, polarization is present. In secondary cell, polarization is absent. In primary cell, the efficiency is low. In secondary cell, efficiency is high. In primary cell, capacity is low. In secondary cell, capacity is high. Primary cells are less costly. Secondary cells are costly. Maintenance is not required for the primary cell. Maintenance is required for secondary cell. And these are the examples: dry cell, mercury cell, zinc chloride cell. Then secondary cells are nickel ion cell, lead acid and lithium ion cell. So this is a comparison between primary and secondary cell. Now these are the basic components of the battery. So first component is positive electrode, that is anode, negative electrode, that is cathode, then electrolyte and separator. Now in our syllabus, the two secondary batteries are included, lead acid battery and lithium ion battery. So first we see lead acid battery. This is the constructional diagram of lead acid battery. This is the battery which is used in the car. So these are the parts, different parts of the battery: anode, cathode, electrolyte, separators, container, bottom blocks, plate connector, vent plug. These are the different parts. So see part one by one. So anode is made up of lead peroxide. Now the color of the lead peroxide is the dark brown, hence this plate is dark brown in color. Then the cathode is made up of pure lead, which is spongy. Electrolyte is sulfuric acid. Then the separators are used. Now what is the function of separator? In this diagram, this is the internal view of battery. So here alternate anode and cathode are plates. Plates are placed. So here the two plates are separated by the separator. So what is the function of the separator? It prevents short circuit of anode and cathode. It is acting as a mechanical spacer, preventing plates to come in contact with each other. It prevents the growth of lead tree on negative plate. It prevents plates from shedding by the active material. So this is the functions of the separator. Then the container is made up of plastic or ceramic. The whole assembly with plates and electrolytes are inserted in the container. then the bottom blocks, the space is provided at the bottoms. So what is the use of that space? This space is provided to prevent short circuit, because the active materials are fallen from the plates, and to avoid the short circuit in the battery, the bottom blocks are provided. Then the plate connector. Now in this case, alternate positive and negative plates are placed. So all positive plates are connected with the same connector, and all negative plates are connected with the different connector. So here is the negative terminal, in which all the negative terminals are connected together. Here is the positive terminal, where all positive plates are connected together with the help of connector. That is the function of connector. Then the vent plug. Vent plug is made up of rubber, and it is screwed to the cover of the cell. Its function is to allow escape of gases, which is formed due to the chemical reactions inside the battery, and it prevents escape of electrolyte. So this is the construction of lead acid battery. This is the view of battery, where the vent plug vent caps are there. Inside that vent caps, vent plug is present. Now the charging process of the lead acid battery. The lead acid battery, the chemical reactions of the lead acid battery is divided into three processes: charging process, discharging process, and recharging process. Okay, so in the charging process, now this is the lead acid battery. Two plates, one is acts as a cathode, another is acts as a anode. So when first time current is applied between these two electrodes, the water inside the electrolyte decomposes. That means it splits into two separate ions. So here the positive hydrogen ion gets attracted towards the negative plate. Okay, so where lead plate is there, and positive hydrogen ion gets attracted towards the lead, it never reacts with the lead. Hence the lead is its original color, that is gray color. Now the negative oxygen gets attracted towards the lead, and due to which lead peroxide is formed. The color of this lead peroxide is dark brown, hence this anode plate becomes dark brown. This is the charging process of the lead acid battery. Now after charging, the potential difference between the positive and anode and negative cathode, which can be used to drive the external circuit. Now for discharging process, the battery, the supply is removed from the battery, and external load resistance is connected. So the electrical energy obtained from chemical reaction is drawn out of the battery to the external circuit, which is called as discharging process. So in the discharging process, reactions are reverses. Okay, so here the sulfuric acid gets decomposes, and its two ions are separated, positive hydrogen ion and negative sulfate ions. So this positive hydrogen ions gets attracted towards lead peroxide, and it reacts along with the H2SO4. Hence here is the reaction: lead peroxide, H2SO4, and the hydrogen. Hence lead sulfate is produced on the anode plate. Similarly, the negative sulfate ions gets attracted towards the cathode. It reacts with lead, and lead sulfate is formed. Now at anode and cathode, both on the both the plate, lead sulfate is formed, and the color of this lead sulfate is white. Hence the whitish layer is on both the electrodes. This is known as discharging process of lead acid battery. Now recharging process, the cell provides the discharge current for limited time, and it is necessary to recharge it after a regular intervals. So for recharging purpose, Again, the EMF is injected through the cell terminals with the help of external supply. So here in the recharging process, if you see the diagram and reactions, at anode, lead peroxide is formed, and at cathode, lead is formed. So whitish layer of lead sulfate is gone and lead is in its original color. Now in this process, from the reactions, water is used and H2SO4 is created. Hence, the specific gravity of H2SO4, which is the charging indicator of the battery, increases. So its value is 1.25 to 1.28 for fully charged battery. The value specific gravity of H2SO4 is 1.25 to 1.28 for fully charged battery, while it is 1.17 to 1.15 for fully discharged battery. Now the rating of the battery. The rating of the battery is always in ampere hours. So ampere hours, the rating of the battery is nothing but the battery capacity. So battery capacity is equal to discharge current in amperes into the time of discharge in hours till voltage falls to a specified value. So suppose the battery capacity is 100 ampere hour, that means the battery is giving 100 ampere for 1 hour. Now the battery capacity depends upon discharge rate, specific gravity of electrolyte, temperature and size of the plates. So if discharge rate increases, battery capacity increases. If more the specific gravity of the electrolyte, more is the capacity. If temperature increases, battery capacity increases. And size of the plates, it depends upon the material deposited on the plates. Now these are the features of the lead acid battery. Capacity of the lead acid battery is 100 to 300 ampere hour. Voltage 2.2 volt for fully charged battery. Cost is low. Internal resistance is very low. Current ratings are high. Ampere hour efficiency is about 90 to 95% with 10 hour rate. Now these are the conditions of fully charged battery. So batteries, when the battery is fully charged, that time the specific gravity of H2SO4 is between 1.25 to 1.28. Then voltage stops to rise and its value is about 2.2 to 2.5 volt. Violet gassing starts as the battery is fully charged, and the color of positive plate becomes dark brown, while the color of negative plate becomes slate gray. So this is the indication of fully charged battery. Now the applications of lead acid battery. It is used in UPS, railway signaling, emergency lighting, automobiles for starting, electrical substation and power stations for compensating feeder drops in case of heavy loads, for energizing the trip coils of the relays and the switch gears. It is also used in mines for supplying and the telephone exchanges. Now the maintenance and precautions to be taken for the lead acid battery. The battery must be recharged immediately when it discharges. You can't drain the battery. Level of electrolyte must be kept above the top of the plates, so the plates remain completely immersed. The rate of charge and discharge should not be exceeded as specified by the manufacturers. Then specific gravity of electrolyte must be between 1.28 to 1.18, because specific gravity is related to internal resistance. If specific gravity increases beyond the limit, then internal resistance increases, which affects the performance of the battery. The temperature of battery should not exceed 45 degree centigrade, and terminals of the battery should not be shorted. So these are some precautions while handling while charging lead acid battery. Now the another type of secondary battery is lithium ion battery. Lithium has highest electromechanical potential, hence it is the most reactive metal. So hence lithium ion is used to achieve high energy and power densities in battery applications. In portable electronic devices, the lithium ion batteries are used. Construction of lithium ion battery. This is the constructional diagram. Now these are the parts of the lithium ion battery. Anode, which is made up of carbon electrode with current collector of copper foil. So here is the anode with the current collector of copper foil. Then cathode, which is the lithium cobalt oxide with current collector of aluminium foil. Separator is porous polymer film. Electrolyte is lithium salt in an organic solvent. And two current collectors, positive and negative. Now these two electrodes used for the lithium battery are made up of materials which can intercalate or absorb the lithium ion. Now intercalation is the process in which absorption of ion in the host material without changing its internal structure, and hence this anode and cathode are made up of such a materials which can absorb the lithium ion easily without disturbing its internal structure. Now charging of lithium ion battery. In lithium ion battery, again the two electrodes, anode and cathode. Now the DC supply is applied to this in between these two electrodes. Due to oxidation process, the cathode loses electrons which are negatively charged. Now these electrons travels through external circuit to the anode, because separator does not allow electrons to travel through the electrolyte. So electrons are moved from cathode to anode externally. Now to maintain the charge balance in the cathode, equal number of lithium ions are dissolved in the electrolytes, and the lithium ions are positively charged. So these lithium ions intercalated within the carbon anode. Intercalated means absorbed in the carbon, and at anode electrons tied with lithium ions. This is the charging process of lithium ion battery. So in charging process, you remember, the electrons from the cathode travel through external circuit to the anode, then for balancing the chemical action, the lithium ions are dissolved in the electron. So some of the lithium ions travels from cathode to anode through this electrolyte, and it is intercalated in the anode. That means without intercalation means without disturbing its internal structure, it is absorbed by the host material. This is the charging process. Now for discharging process, again we have to remove the battery, and the external load is connected between the anode and cathode. So in the discharging process, the opposite reactions occurs. So this time anode releases ions, lithium ions and electrons. So here now the electron flow is opposite, it is from anode to cathode, and the lithium ions are dissolved in the electrolyte. As the electrons are moving from the external circuit, due to the flow of electrons in external circuit, the current is established, and device which is connected to battery is operated. When cathode is full of lithium ions, discharging stops and battery needs to be recharged again. This is the discharging process. So during discharging process, we have to write the reactions also. So during the discharging, lithium is oxidized and lithium ion released from the carbon along with the electrons. At cathode, lithium ions are absorbed by lithium dioxide and electrons are absorbed from the external circuit. So these reactions are very, very important. Now the applications of lithium ion battery, it is used in cameras and calculators, mobile phones, portable radios and laptops, aerospace applications, used in cardiac pacemakers and other implantable devices. Advantages: the energy density of lithium ion battery is high, the cell voltage is high, which is about 3.6 volt. It is light in weight and compact in size. It handles many charging discharging cycles. It's charged for longer time. It has no memory effect. No maintenance is required. It is available in varieties of shape and sizes. Disadvantages: its performance is affected due to high temperature. It lasts up to 3 years after manufacturing. It is costly. It can burst into flames if separator gets damaged. It requires protection circuit to maintain voltage and current within the safe limit. Now this is a comparison between lead acid and lithium ion battery. In the lead acid battery, anode is lead peroxide, and in lithium ion battery it is carbon. Then cathode is lead. In lithium ion battery, lithium cobalt oxide. Electrolyte is H2SO4. In lithium ion battery, lithium salt with organic solvent. Specific power of lead acid battery is 180 watt per kg. For lithium ion battery, it is 340 watt per kg. Lead acid battery is having low cost. Lithium ion battery is costly. For lead acid battery, maintenance is required. For lithium ion battery, maintenance free. Rated voltage for lead acid is 2.2 volt. For lithium ion battery, it is 3.6 volt. This is the comparison. Now the connections of the batteries. So batteries are connected in series grouping. Say in the series grouping, current remain same. So this is the diagram of series grouping of batteries. Now in the parallel grouping, the batteries are connected in parallel. In parallel, the voltage remain same for the battery. So the question is when to use series grouping and parallel grouping. In the series grouping, current flowing through each battery is same, but the voltage is more. So whenever the requirement of voltage is more, connect the batteries in series grouping. In the parallel grouping, we are getting high current capacity. So whenever we require high current capacity, parallel grouping is preferred. Now this is series parallel grouping. In this diagram, here the batteries are connected in series, and all the series batteries are connected again in parallel. So whenever the requirement is high current capacity as well as high voltage, series parallel grouping is preferred. Now the methods of battery charging. This is a constant current method. In the constant current method, here if you see in the diagram, batteries are connected in series across a constant DC supply. Here variable resistance is given so that to for maintaining the current across the batteries constant. So in this particular constant current method, the charging time required is more. Hence in the modern chargers, the variation of charging rate can be done. So for that, the number of charging circuits are used. So initially high charging rate is used, and later on lower charging rates are preferred. Now constant voltage method. In the constant voltage method, the batteries are connected in parallel. If you see, then the cascade resistances are used here for charging the batteries on DC supply. In this particular type of method, as they are connected in parallel, voltage across each battery is same, but the charging current varies according to the state of the charge of each battery. And at the end, when the battery is fully charged, the voltage across the battery is equal to the voltage of the bus bar. This is the constant voltage method. Now the rectifier method. When DC supply is not available, rectifier method is used. Now in this diagram, a bridge rectifier is used, and here is a step down transformer for stepping down the voltage for required voltage level for rectifier circuit. This rectifier converts AC to DC and battery can be charged. Now depth of discharging. Depth of discharging is the capacity of battery in ampere hours, that is discharge from a fully charged battery divided by a battery nominal capacity. Depth of discharge gives us the safe discharge voltage for the battery, and it is specified by the manufacturer. It is expressed in percentage. Here is one example of depth of discharging. If 100 ampere battery is discharged at 40 ampere for 30 minutes, then its depth of discharge is 20%. So depth of discharge is very important for batteries like lead acid and lithium ion battery, because the life of the battery is depends upon the depth of the discharge. Thank you. Here the unit number 6, it's completed.